Yeah, good morning. Right. Now, what have we done in the last class? Hello? May I know what have we done in the last class?
Light sensors,
Light sensors.
photo emissive sensors,
Okay. Right.
strain
Okay.
gauge
Right.
based on sensors.
Okay. Fine. 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 Okay. Right. So now, last class we have discussed about what was called as the light sensors. Basically, the photoelectric effect was responsible for the construction of the light sensor. Under the light sensor, we have totally three different effects which are going to be there. One was called the photoemissive effect, due to which you can develop photoemissive sensor. In photoemissive sensor, you will be having a cathode. When light ray falls on the cathode, okay, the electrons are going to be liberated, and you make the electrons to move towards the anode, by which you are going to develop an anode current. The amount of anode current developed is proportional to the intensity of the light. So, in order to make the more anode current to be developed, you have used what are called as the photomultipliers, which you have called it as dinodes. Okay, you are going to use, you have used dinodes, which are the photomultipliers, right? Then next we have discussed what was called as the photoconductive sensors, okay, which are also called as the light dependent resistor, that is LDR. Okay, those are also called as the photoresistor. So LDR are nothing but the semiconducting material, where the resistance of the semiconducting material increases with the increase in the light intensity. So that was the basic concept behind photoconductive sensors. Now we have some few materials we have discussed, like lead solenoid, lead telluride, okay, so which are the semiconducting material. Now, as the light intensity changes the resistance, in turn the change in resistance will have an impact on the voltage and the current. So now you are going to make the constant current source in the circuit. If you are going to make the constant current source, when the light falls on the LDR material, the resistance of the LDR material changes. As you have made a constant current source, the velocity is, sorry, the voltage is going to change us. Therefore, the change in the voltage is due to the change in the resistance, and in turn the change in resistance is due to what was called as the intensity of the light. That was your the photoconductive sensors. Okay, then the third one was photovoltaic sensor, wherein you are going to use what are called as the photoresistor, that is photodiodes you are going to use, and phototransistors you are going to use. Okay, right. So if you are used photodiode, it's an NP junction. Okay, in the phototransistor you have used the NPN junction and the PNP junction. Okay, so in that you are going to use what are going to be called as, okay, so you are going to use what are going to be called as your the NPN voltage, means voltage you are going to get. Okay, that means to say, now in all the three cases, so conductivity, emissivity and voltaic effect is going to be considered. Okay, then later on you have discussed about what was called as the strain gauges. Okay, so the strain gauges, how the strain gauges are going to be used for the purpose of measuring the strain. So that is what we have discussed in the last class. Okay, right. Now we'll go further and we'll understand this last bit of the chapter called as the encoders. Okay, right. So let me just start off my work. Okay, today we shall discuss what are called as encoders. Okay, so this is the one which is going to be there. We'll discuss what are called as the encoders. Okay, First of all, encoders are also called as the optical encoders. Encoders are also called as the optical encoders, or it's also called as the position encoders. It's also called as the position encoders. Okay, right. Now, the purpose is, what is the purpose of the encoder? Is mainly the encoders are the devices used to detect. It is used to detect the position, okay, velocity, acceleration, and direction of rotation, okay, of any rotating member. Okay, so this is very, very important. First, okay, let us go simplest way. Okay, now the encoders are nothing but what? The encoders are nothing but the devices mainly used to determine the position of the rotating member, velocity of the velocity at which the member is rotating, or the acceleration at which the rotating at which the member is rotating, and the direction of rotation, whether it is rotating in the clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So this is what is going to be present. Okay, right. Now these encoders are rigidly fixed to. Okay, this is very important. These are the members which are rigidly fixed onto the rotating member. Okay, which is the one which are rigidly fixed onto the rotating members. Okay, like you have shafts. Okay, or the what are called as your bearings, etc., etc. Okay, so onto this. These members are going to be rigidly fixed. Okay. Now we'll try to understand the different types of encoders. Basically, the types of encoders are going to be, first one, we have what is called as the incremental encoder. Okay, we have what is called as incremental encoder, and we have what is called as the absolute encoder. Okay, incremental encoder and absolute encoder. Okay, right. So now we'll try to understand one by one. Okay, we'll discuss what is called as incremental encoder. Okay, right. Now, what do you mean by incremental encoder? First of all, let's understand that the encoder. Is it audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. First of all, encoders are nothing but the devices which are fixed onto the rotating member. Okay, we have a shaft. Now, it is not possible for me to put my the tachometer so that to measure what is the speed. Okay, so it is not possible to calculate the velocity. It is somewhere embedded within the system. Therefore, I want to know continuously, means without any contact, I want to know what is the velocity or the acceleration or the method of rotation. So I am going to use what are going to be called as the encoders. Okay, basically now encoders, as I told, okay, if I am going to have what is called as a shaft, something like this, okay, right? Shaft something like this. Okay. Now the encoders are going to be attached like this. Okay. Now if you assume the encoders are nothing but a round structure, so encoders are going to be attached at the end. So as and when the shaft is going to rotate, the encoder which are present, okay, or which are embedded onto the or fixed onto the shaft, they will also start to rotate. Okay. Now this is what is the basic principle. Just understand this first. Okay. Right. Now, before we go further, I just have a small video for you. Okay. Just observe. Don't worry about that. I will again explain. Again, play this and explain to you. Okay. Right. Just listen. Okay.
Also called a shaft encoder, can be used in positioning and motor speed feedback applications. A rotary encoder, also called a shaft encoder, can be used in positioning and motor speed feedback applications. In this video, we explain the function of an incremental rotary encoder. Incremental rotary encoders use disks which contain transparent sections that are equally spaced. A light-emitting diode serves as sender, and its light is detected by a photodetector. Therefore, the encoder can generate a sequence of...
Okay, now you just observe, just I have passed it. Now this is what is called as your the shaft, which is going to be there. And to the end of the shaft, okay, so we have what is called as a device. This device is what was called as the encoder. Okay, how it is going to happen, I'll just explain. So that when I'm going to explain, at least you should have an idea how the encoder is going to be. Okay, that's why I'm just showing here. I'll explain again. Just have a look.
The output is measured in pulses per revolution, which can be used to determine either the position or the rotational speed. To detect the rotational sense, the encoder needs two tracks. The sense of rotation determines which signal coming from track A or track B is leaving. Here, you can see the signal form coming from clockwise rotation. To have a comparison, you see now the signal form coming from counterclockwise rotation. Now the signal coming from track.
Now this is used to understand whether it is rotating in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. Okay.
Watch also our next videos. Can generate a sequence of pulses. The output is measured in pulses per revolution, which can be used to determine either the position or the rotational speed.
Okay, right. Now just observe here. Okay. Now we have what is called as a pulse. Okay. So this is what is called as your the encoder. The encoder is the one which is a circular disc. Okay. Now in this circular disc, what I am having is, okay, as and when the shaft is going to rotate, the circular disc is also going to rotate. Okay. And on either side of the circular disc, we have what is called as a photo source. Okay. And on the other side, we have a photo detector. Okay. Right. Now, this, if you observe on the surface of your the circular track, we have certain openings. Okay. There are some transparent opening and there is some portion which are opaque. Okay. Right. Now, when it will be when the shaft is going to rotate, as I said, the track is also going to rotate along with the shaft. Now this photo detector is going to receive the signal from the photo source whenever the light is going to passes through this particular slots. Okay, so just this is the understanding. Please observe now. Okay, now this is how it is going to be. Right. Now this incremental encoder, this generally the broad classification of encoders are going to be linear encoder and rotary encoder. Okay, broad classification is linear and rotary encoder. Okay, but most generally the rotary encoder is going to be the one which is used. That's why we are using the word called as the encoders. Okay, so encoders are nothing but the devices used for the purpose of measuring the position, velocity, acceleration, and direction of rotation. Okay, right. Now, incremental encoder, it's going to be like this. Okay. Now, we have what is called as a shaft. Okay. Now, sorry. So, a circular disc is going to be there. Okay. Right. Now, circular disc has been fixed onto what is called as the shaft. Okay. Now, if I take the other view of it, this is my the disc in the right view. Okay. And this is what is your the shaft which is present there. Okay, right. And we'll just consider this. Okay, right. Now on this side of, now we have in this circular disc, we have uniformly spaced the transparent and the opaque segment. Okay, for the clarity I am just writing only 4. Okay, so there might be 16 to 32 number, okay, 16 to 32 number of these slots are going to be present. Okay, so possibility, I'll tell, explain what is this. Okay, right. Now these are what, this is going to be your the pattern disk. Okay, this is your transparent segment, this is going to be the opaque segment. Okay, right. Now we have on this side of the disc, we have what is called as a light source. Now this is going to be your LED. okay, I just have a little space. Okay, and this is going to be your photo detector. Okay, right. Then we have what is called as a small graph here, which is the time. This is output of the photo detector. Okay, right. Now just observe carefully. Now this is your what? This is your pattern disk. Okay, right. Now, what is this is called as? This is your line of action. Okay, right. Now just observe. Now in case of your incremental encoder, in case of incremental encoder, basically the shaft starts to rotate. The shaft starts to rotate along with this pattern disk will also start to rotate. Now on the left side of the pattern disk we have LED. What is the purpose of LED? What for it is used? LED is
light source, sir.
It's a light source. Okay, it emits the light. Okay, LED emits the light. Okay, now that light passes through this what is called as your pattern disk. Okay, and on the other side of the pattern disk you have a photo detector. What is the purpose of photo detector? The photo detector receives the light and detects the intensity of the light. Okay, now just observe in the actual practice. Now in order to get this photo, in order to get the light detected by the photo detector, what is the line of action? The light should passes from LED, and if it passes through what segment the photo detector will receive the light? Will the photo detector receive the light continuously? You understand? Is the photo detector receives the light continuously? Sir, no. Now here, just observe.
To detect the rotational sense, the encoder needs two tracks. The output is measured.
Now just observe. Okay, how the red light, red one is coming. Okay, when it passes through what?
To detect the rotational sense, the encoder needs two tracks. The sensor rotation determines which signal incremental rotary encoders use disks, which contains transparent sections that are equally spaced. A light emitting diode serves as sender and its light is detected by a...
Yeah, now just observe. Okay, now just observe. You have a transmitter. That is what is that I told as light emitting diode. And on the other side, you have a receiver. That is a photo detector. Okay. Now, when the photo detector will receive the signal? Is it photo detector receives the signal at all the times?
No, sir.
When it is going to receive the signal?
When light passes through the transparent segment.
Okay, when the light passes through a transparent segment. Okay, right? Is it clear to you? Understanding? Right, when the light passes through a transparent segment, at that moment you are going to get the signal. That means what? I am going to get what is called as a pulse. Okay, I am going to get what is called as a pulse. So this is called as the pulse. Pulse is nothing but what? A digital signal. Okay, I am going to get a digital signal in the form of the pulse whenever the photo detector receives the signal. Now the line of action should be what now? Okay, in order to get the photo detector to get the signal, LED transparent segment. Okay, so right, so LED, right, LED light source. Okay, should pass through the transparent segment, and then the photo detector receives the signal. When the opaque segment is going to come during the rotation, when the opaque segment is going to come, okay, at that moment the photo detector will not receive the signal for that much duration of the time. Then again, what is going to happen when there is going to be one more the transparent segment? I am going to get one more signal. Okay, right. Now I am going to get the pulse at an intermittent period of time. Okay, so this intermittency is because of what? Is because of what is called as your the transparent portion. And this is because of what is called as the opaque portion. Okay, for every transparent, you are going to get a signal, and then followed by the time that which the shaft is going to rotate. Okay, and then it is going to be no signal. Then you are going to get the transparent signal. Now we call it as incremental encoder. Why we call it as incremental encoder is important. Okay, right. Now what this number of pulses indicates to you? What the number of pulses indicates? What is the number of pulses indicates?
So number of signals with respect to time.
Yeah, number of signal respect to time. Okay, right. What is that to do with the rotation angle? Can you detect the rotation angle by you knowing the number of pulses?
360 by number of transparent segments.
Now here, how many number of the transparent segments are going to be present here? So we have totally 8 number of transparent segments. That means now this is the whatever I am shown is just for the purpose for you to understand. This is the simplest and not existing type of incremental encoder. Okay, now if you observe here, the incremental encoder is going to have so many number of slots. Are you seeing this video, the snapshot? What are you seeing on your screen now? Hello?
Snapshot.
Yeah. Okay, right. Now if you observe, now you can observe, these are all the transparent segment. Okay. Now there will be more than 16 to 30. You can have maximum of up to 32 number of segments, transparent segments. Okay, now for the purpose of clarity, I have just shown only 8. It means what? Now if I am going to have 8, the total number of positions is going to be how much? Number of positions that you can able to detect is going to be, number of positions will be equal to what now? What is the number of positions now? Number of positions will be equal to 360 divided by n, where n is the number of transparent segment. Okay, that is 360 divided by 8. Okay, so it is totally 45 degrees. Okay, means what this indicates now, if you are going to get a signal at this point, okay, now what does it indicate now? If it starts from here, okay, if it starts from here, the rotation starts from here. Are you understanding? Please understand. The rotation starts from here in rotation, clockwise rotation. Now when it comes to this, what does it mean now? Okay, what is the angle that is detected? What is the position? Where is the position of the shaft at this point? At this point, what is the position of the shaft? One pulse means what? What is the angle? Tell me, first pulse means how much angle, yeah?
45
degrees. Okay, now at which the first pulse indicates it is 45 degree. Second pulse is what? Second pulse is going to be 90. Like that means every time what should happen? The pulse should increment. The pulses should increment for one rotation. For one rotation, you are going to get 8 pulses. Okay. Then again, what is going to happen? Then more number of pulses. Okay. Now let us say the total number of pulses is going to be 10. Okay. Right. It doesn't mean it is good. It has rotated by 360 plus another 90. Okay. It is totally what? So two rotation it has made. Okay. That is 360 plus the other rotation. Okay. Now that is what is very clearly given shown here. Now you can observe clearly. Now probably you can get. Right, observe.
A rotary encoder, also called.
Now just observe. You can. Yeah. Now just observe.
And motor speed feedback applications. In this video, we.
Now just observe here the number of turns you just observe and the angle. Okay, right. Now here the number of turns was what? Number of turns were 0. Okay, and the angle is going to be 303. Now you can observe how to calculate the resolution. What is the resolution of this particular encoder? What we are using now? What is the resolution of this encoder? What I have drawn now? This encoder, what is the resolution? What is the minimum angle that you can able to detect? What is the minimum angle that you can able to detect here? Can you detect 30 degrees? Yes or no? Can you detect 30 degree rotation of 30 degree here? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Can you detect rotation of 30 degree here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Now this incremental encoder, okay, basically, okay, whatever I have shown here, okay, is the number of pulses you are going to get. The number of pulses is the one which indicates, okay, the number of pulses is the one which indicates the rotation angle, okay, the number of pulses indicates the rotation angle which is going to be present. More the number of the segment, transparent segments are going to be, you will be having more number of angle to be detected. Okay, in this case, 360 divided by 8, you can have 45 degree is the minimum angle that you can able to measure. Okay, right. The number of pulses is proportional to the total amount of rotation that you can make. Okay, now once you know the position, if you take the first derivative of the position, you are going to get what is called the velocity. If you take the second derivative, you are going to get what is called as the acceleration. Okay, so this is with respect to what is called as the case of the incremental encoder. Okay, right. Then if we go further to the second one called as the second one is going to be called as your absolute encoder. Okay, right. So an absolute encoder is nothing but a device. Okay, so in continuation with the same encoder. So in case of the previous one, that is your incremental encoder, the amount is going to be get incremented. Okay, so after every rotation, okay, the amount is going to be get incremented to know the rotation angle. But in absolute encoder of the devices used for the measurement of angular displacement again. Now the output of absolute encoder, okay, output is going to be in the form of the binary number. Okay, the output is going to be in the form of the binary number. Okay, the output is going to be in the form of the binary number, which are going to be unique. The output is going to be in the form of the binary number, which are going to be unique. Okay, now that is the case with respect to the absolute encoder. Okay, now to understand the absolute encoder, okay, we'll just have a small diagram now. We'll have three different tracks. Okay, right. So this is one track. Okay, right. Then we have one more track here. Okay. Then we have one more track. Now three tracks that I wrote. Okay. Okay, right. So these are the tracks which are going to be present. Okay, now we'll call this as what are going to be called as this is my track three. Okay, this is my track three. So this is my track two and this is my track one. Okay, so these are the three tracks which are going to be present. Okay, right. Means what? First track, second track, third track. Means what? You will be having the binary number is going to be, the binary digits is going to be what? Number of tracks is going to be, number of tracks will be equal to three. Okay. So once you have number of tracks, number of positions is going to be, number of positions is going to be, is equal to 2 to the power of n, where n is the number of tracks. So it becomes 2 power 3, it is 8. Okay. Now, if I am going to have a binary number of 3 tracks, okay, for a binary input of 3, for a binary input of 3, the total number of outputs that you are going to get is 8. Okay, it means you know that it is 3 digits, 0, 0, 0, okay, 0, 0, 1, then 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, okay, 4, then 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. So these are the 8 positions that you are going to get. That means the output that you are going to get is going to be, these are the output, that is 0, 0, 0 is the output, because 0, 0, 1 is the output. Now, what do you mean by 0, 0, 0 is simple. That means now each track, okay, each track will have, okay, like, please understand, each track are going to have corresponding photo sensor and the photo detector. Okay, so each sensor will have, by the side of each sensor, you will be having one photo sensor, on the other side, you will be having photo detector. Therefore, three photo sensors are going to be there and three photo detectors are going to be there for this particular condition. Okay, for the number of tracks, there are three different photo sensor and three different photo detectors are going to be present. Now, if I'm going to get zero, that means now we'll understand clearly. Now we have we'll made a sector, right? And then we have what is called as the track one, okay? And we have what is called as track two, and then we have what is called as track three, okay? Right? Then we'll try to understand what is the angle of rotation. Okay, so totally how many tracks that I'm going to have now? Totally I have 8 different tracks. Okay, by making this, so totally 8 different tracks are going to be there. So we have what is going to be called as the track number. This is your sector 1, sector, sorry, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Totally 8 tracks are going to come as I started from 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are the total number of tracks which are going to be present. Now, in case of if the output is going to be 0, okay, so this is nothing but what? The output of your what? Output of encoder. Okay, output of encoder. Now, if the output of encoder is nothing but 0, 0, 0, okay, it means what? I am not getting the signal in through the first track. Second track also, I am not getting the signal. Third track also, I am not getting the signal. Okay, that means what is going to happen is, now this is going to be opaque. This is opaque. Okay, this is the first track. Please observe. This is your the first track. This is the first track. Sorry. The first segment. In the first segment, I am having the output as 0, 0, 0. It means what? I am not getting the signal. That is, here it is none, here it is none, and here it is none. That is what? Off, off, and off. So now what is the angle of rotation? It starts from here. So 0. Now this is going to be 45 degrees. Okay, what is that you can able to measure? It is 0 to 45 degrees. Then next is 0, 0, 1. Okay. What do you mean 0, 0, 1 means? 0, it is off. Okay. Then second track is also off. So we have 1 that is on. That means second one. So here, light will not pass through here. Light will not pass through here. Light will pass through here. Okay. Now I will just make the shading here. Okay. Shading is the portion where the light passes. Right? Understand? Shaded portion is the one where the through which the light passes. Okay. Right. So third one, the next one is going to be what? 0, 1, 0. That means 0, that is no light passes. 1, the light is going to pass. So that means the second sector, no light passes. Then light passes through this. That's why I am shading. Okay. Then here, no light is going to pass. Okay. Then what is going to happen now? 0 to 45 degree. The next is 45 to 90 degree here. Then here off. Then it is 90 degrees to another 45 degree and 35 degree. Okay. Next third one is 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1 means off. Okay. Then on and on. Okay. Now this is off. And here it is going to be on. Light passes through here. And again, the light passes through here. Okay. Right. So here, 135 degrees to 180 degrees. Then the fourth one is going to be what? Now this is done, this is done, this is done. Next is going to be 100. Okay. Now light passes through the fourth one. Then on, off, off. Okay. Fourth one. Now here, the light passes. Okay. Here there is no light, there is no light. Okay, right, that is what? Okay, right. Then fifth one is going to be, the angle is going to be 180 degrees to 225 degrees. Then the fifth one is 101. Okay, 101 means on, off, on. Okay, fifth one. On means shade, then off, no light passes through, then again on. Okay, right. Then the angle is going to be 225 degrees to 270 degrees. Okay, then next is going to be 110. Okay, next is 110. Now means on and off. Okay, sixth one. Okay, on, that means shaded, then again another shade. Okay, and off. Okay, so it is 270 to another 45 degrees, 315 degree. Last one is what? It is 111. Light rays pass through this track 1, track 2, and also track 3. Okay, that is light rays pass through this, then again light rays pass through this shading, and again light rays pass through this. Okay, that means what? All are going to be on 315 degrees to 360 degrees. Now, if you observe carefully, in this case, you will be having unique output. Okay, so for no other angles, you are going to get 0, 0, 0 as the output. Okay, so once you got 0, 0, 0 as the output, the position of the shaft is going to be at 45 degrees. Okay, then 0, 0, 1. Like that, you are going to get the unique output throughout the members. Okay, now this is what is called as the basis of what is called as the absolute encoder. Okay, right. Now, with this, we have completed the first module, that is called as the transducers. Okay, now before we go further, okay, I'll just summarize this chapter. Okay, let us summarize this chapter, is number 3. Okay, right. So what we have discussed was called as the transducers and sensors. Okay, right. So we have discussed the definition of transducer. Please remember, definition of transducers we have discussed. Okay, right. Then classification of transducers. Okay, remember, classification of transducers. Okay, now various classifications are going to be there. Number 1, depending upon the input phenomenon. Okay, depending upon the input phenomenon. Okay, so you have discussed primary transducer and you have discussed secondary transducers. Okay, now all this I have done, I am only naming, that's all. Okay, second one is going to be, it is based on the output. Okay, based on the output. So we have discussed analog transducers and digital transducers. Then third one is going to be based on what is called as the energy. So it is the active transducer and what is called as the passive transducer. Okay, active transducer and passive transducers. Okay, then we have what are called as the mass sensing element, mass sensing, then elastic sensing element and thermal elements. Okay, last one, there is one more called as the input transducer and output transducers. Okay, input transducers and output transducers. Okay, then sixth one is, so depending upon the type of measurement, mechanical transducer, electrical transducer, okay, right, magnetic transducer, okay, and thermal transducer, etc. Okay, so these are the classification of transducers. Okay, then later on you have discussed about what are called as the sensors. Okay, then the classification of sensors. Okay, right. Then next started with the different types of sensors. The first one was what is called as the Hall effect sensors. Okay, the first one was the Hall effect sensors. Okay, so basically this Hall effect sensor is nothing but it's a magnetic sensor. Okay, whenever the straight line path of the charges, if it is going to be deflected towards a negatively charged particle, there exists what is called as a current. The voltage is going to be developed. That means a potential difference is going to be developed across the conducting material perpendicular to the application of magnetic field. So this is called as Hall effect, developed by the person called as Hall. Okay, now the amount of Hall voltage, that is VH, okay, is going to be proportional to what is called as VI by T. Okay, so now if I take out the proportionality constant, I have told it is K suffix H V into I divided by T. Okay, right, where KH is called as the Hall coefficient, B is the magnetic flux density, I is the current, and T is the thickness. T is the thickness. Okay, right. Now, if you are going to make, thickness is going to be constant. Okay, so thickness of the material is constant. And if you make the current as constant, make I as constant. Okay, if you make I as constant, okay, then VH is directly proportional to what is called as B. That means the Hall effect sensor is called as a magnetic sensor used to determine what is called as magnetic flux density. Okay, used to determine what is called as magnetic flux density. Okay, so that is the basic thing. And then here we are going to use what are called as the semiconducting material. Remember, okay, we are going to use what is called as semiconducting material. Okay, so this is another one. Okay, right. Then next is going to be what is called as proximity sensors. Okay, so proximity sensors. Okay, right. So proximity sensors are the one greatly used to detect the presence of the object or what is the closeness of the object. Okay, presence of the object or closeness of the object in front of the sensor. Okay, so there are many types of proximity sensors we have discussed. Okay, so number one, so we have discussed proximity switches. Proximity switches. Okay, right. Then number two, it is eddy current. Okay, eddy current type proximity sensor. Okay, right. Then third one is pneumatic type proximity sensor. Then fourth one was capacitive type proximity sensor. Fifth one was photoelectric type proximity sensors. Okay, right. Now these are all the different types of proximity sensors which are going to be there, and with the diagram I explained clearly, right. Then next was called as the light sensor. Okay, light sensor. The effect is going to be photoelectric effect, and the three types are going to be photo emissive sensor, second one is photoconductive sensor, third one is photovoltaic sensor. Okay, right. So that is one type of sensor. Then next one you have discussed what are called as the strain gauges. Okay, so here foil type strain gauge, okay, and wire type strain gauge. Okay, right. Then in today's class you have discussed what are called as the encoders. Okay, so here we have what is called as the absolute encoder and what is called as the incremental encoders. Okay, right. Okay, now these are the things which we have done in the case of what are called as transducers and sensors. Okay, now the question, the possibility of the questions are going to be mainly on the classification of transducers. Okay, you may get a question on classification of transducers and on the Hall effect sensor and the some of the types of the proximity sensor or some types of light sensors. Okay, right. So this is about the first module, okay, which are going to be there. Now please concentrate on writing the examples for the types of transducers that you are going to write, and then in case of Hall effect sensor in the test also you observed, okay, try to write clearly, write the mathematical equation. Okay, in the test many of you have missed out writing the mathematical equation for the sensor. It is very important. Okay, so you should write the mathematical equation for the sensor, which is VH proportional to BI by T, and don't forget to explain, okay, the individual component. Okay, that is what some of you have missed it out. Okay, and in Hall effect sensor what you need to write, okay, specifically is that if it is going to be a metal, okay, the metal, the amount of value of voltage developed is going to be very, very smaller. Okay, so hence we are going to use what are called as the semiconducting material. Okay, if I am going to use semiconducting material, it is possible for us to dope the known number of electrons into it. Okay, so there is a concept called as doping. Okay, now that is due to that it is possible for you to get a more amount of electrical voltage. Okay, so that those small concepts that you need to mention in the write-up of the Hall effect sensor. And if any application is going to be asked, okay, So don't forget to make an application with the diagram. Okay, one application I have shown, which is a fuel level indicator. So write that fuel level indicator and make it up. Okay, so that is another important one. Okay, right. Then next is we have a proximity sensor. So specifically eddy current type, pneumatic type, capacitive type, and photoelectric types. Okay, right. In all the cases, write the equation. Sorry, write the figure, and explanation is very much essential in all those particular cases. Okay, and next is with respect to strain gauges. Okay, so I have told about the importance of foil type compared to the wire type, because foil type is going to give you the more amount of surface area. And some application that you need to write, where how these strain gauges are going to be used for the purpose of measurement of the displacement. Okay, that is one cantilever beam example I have given. Okay, and for the measurement of the force, that is what is called a proving ring. Okay, proving ring, that is what I have given. Okay, so that those two things you need to write. Okay, then again in the encoders, optical and the incremental encoders. Okay, and the light sensors. Okay, so I just thought to have some discussion and close off the session. Okay, so I just done with my the transducers and sensors. Okay, so you just type your USN number and you can leave for the class. You can leave. Type your USN number in the chat box.